Hello YouTube, this is Bonsai Bingo 88 here with another episode of 7 Days to Die. Welcome to the morning of day 2. We're about 35 minutes or so game time from the start of the official signaling of morning here in Nava's game. We're going to go ahead and step outside anyways. Like I mentioned in the day 1 episode, all the zombies are going to walk at all times unless it's going to be the 7 day horde. We are going to treat this as though it's The Walking Dead, which is one of my favorite, if not the favorite, zombie shows of our post-apocalyptic shows of all time. Today we're going to venture out just a little bit. We don't have a lot of food or water. We need some supplies. So we are going to go ahead and we're going to head north. We have a little temporary marker up here. Of course, we're going to grab everything we find in the birds' nests. Yep, there we go. That is the official dawning of morning. So it looks like 2200-06 is going to be the nighttime. We're going to pick up all of these yucca fruits here. If you combine the yucca fruits with empty glass jars that we pick up, or after we drink water, you get these things called yucca juice, which will allow us to regain our stamina much quicker than if we were just regularly hydrating. Excuse me, it's been a long day at work. I'm a little bit tongue-tied. Not really a bunch of meetings, but just a lot of stuff in general, so I'm still in that unwind phase from work. So looks like we came across an apartment building here in the middle of nowhere. We're going to stay undetected for as long as we can. Stop. Oh, whoa! Oh, wow. Oh, hello. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. Hope you guys enjoyed that. Let's start taking these guys out at a distance. Make sure none are spawning behind us. That was not cool. There's that one. Sorry about that. I don't really have much to talk about when I'm trying to focus. Every now and then you want to check behind you. You're not going to lure all these zombies back towards our house. And thin up this herd a little bit. I don't know how I'm missing him from this close. Hope you guys really enjoyed that nice little shock factor that this game is able to provide right off the bat. Alright, we're going to go ahead and loot while we can. Oh, hello, you're not dead yet. So it looks like the arrow is going to, once it's dead on, is going to be just a little to the right of the crosshair. Once again, don't want to go any further back than this. Oh, where did you come from? So I'm not really worried. And there's a cactus there. So always keep aware of your surroundings. now we can go ahead and start scavenging a little bit. I know there was an issue with this game back in the past with the, I guess what they call like the hitbox. I should have gone melee for that one. Come on. There we go. There we go. Footsteps and get a little freaked out sometimes. We will take care of the Gorblocks as soon as I get rid of this little horde that spawned right on top of me. I hate these jerking ones. And of course these big boys here are going to have a little bit more HP than the average zombie. Making sure he's dead. Pretty much they're not a gore block, we didn't search them. Unless we, actually that's not entirely true. We have a crawler somewhere. Unless they fixed it, guess what? We lost out on all that stuff. But we're gonna go ahead and take this stuff off here. Okay, so I'm not going crazy. I know for a fact I just heard a zombie. So, pretty much, it looks like they got rid of it. The option to loot the core blocks if you haven't looted them yet, which is a shame because that was a lot of good loot we could have had. Before we go any further, we're going here, the basics. What are we missing from this? We need some wood, and we need some to get out of the sun. So I have no idea where I'm going to build for my, my ultimate base for this playthrough. I know some of the YouTubers that I watch, they usually have these massive builds that they like to do. I have not given it much thought yet, unfortunately. Alright, so we are definitely overheating. We are going to get this, and we're going to try and find a way inside. Oh, I get this bird nest too. Never, ever, ever forego bird's nest. Ooh, we found some bullets. Another water. There we go. We're gonna go ahead and eat this. Alright, so real quick, we're gonna do this. Drop that. We're going to scrap that. that and that. Some yucca juice, like I mentioned previously in the episode. I'm gonna come back over here. Yes, I know you're getting really, really overheated. I'm sorry. We're going to make some more arrows. Let's try to make some room. I don't need these sandwiches yet. We're going to eat this. We can't drink because we can. And that should do it for now. Do that. Okay, what we're gonna do is, yes, we're gonna go in here. Craft those. We're gonna do this. I'm gonna jump up. This. And we are now out of the heat. So our temperature should start going down here a little bit. Yep, there it goes. It went from 112 to 111. For now, we're going to keep our weapon on us. We are going to try and build another stone axe, but we are missing stone. Yes. Alright, we're not going to worry about that right now. We'll come back to it. We're going to do a little bit of, a little bit of scavenging. So has anyone here played 70s Dead before? I'm open to a lot of tips. Maybe you guys experienced something in your playthroughs that I have not come through yet, or I might not come through yet, or might not come across. I'm always willing to hear, hey, Bonzai, you didn't do this. Hey, Bonzai, you didn't do that. I'm cool with that. Play this on PC, probably make the same mistakes that I make on that playthrough. One thing is, I don't have, at least I'm not aware of the capabilities to put any PC games up. I have yet to figure that out. So, yes, I know we're going back out in the heat, and it's just to get some stone so we can break down the door. And loot whatever I find en route to that. There's no way I can hear that close from way over here. You know what? Let's see if this will work. Desperate times call for oh, yes, right. I need two more. One more. There we go. We will search all of this on the way out, or at least we'll come back, one of the two. My main concern is getting through here. We might even stay here for the night. I don't know yet. So what is your guys' most anticipated game for 2017 going to be? I see myself buying only two games this year, unless I pick up something for the channel later. One thing is going to be Ghost Recon Wildlands. I'll be getting that for the Xbox One. And the other one is State of Decay 2, which I am torn between PlayStation and Xbox just because I have friends that play both consoles. So that might be another one of these games that I buy for multiple consoles, unless... Give it a quick second. Something went wrong with the game. There we go. Sorry about that. I have no idea what's going on. Now this has never happened to me playing on Xbox. So I do apologize for that. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to spend the rest of today scavenging for stuff. And then in the morning, we will head back to our house, unload what we find. Actually, let's go ahead and start doing this right now. Can we break anything down? Yes, we can. That can be broken down. Let's go ahead and make more yucca juice. Oh, I need four per. Okay, so I can only make one. Let's go ahead and make one more. This we're gonna go ahead and eat. Blueberries we're gonna go ahead and eat. Eat that too. Okay, so apparently they did not fix the lag issue. So apparently we are in a very high spawn area. This happened back on the PC whenever you go into this town called Dyersville. Oh god, don't spawn, or don't freeze. There's a possibility of someone nearby. I have this feeling that I'm going to get smacked by a zombie. Like, I'm... Okay. But we're still undetected, so it's just... Okay, we're good for now. But this lag is just... It's going to kill me. And this is the most empty apartment building I've ever seen in my life. So make sure you scavenge everything, because you will, the more you scavenge, the more experience you get in that category. And the more you scavenge, the higher it goes, which means the faster the loot timer goes. I remember back in the day when the loot timer was an option. Oh, and also you'll get better stuff, too. So, a lot of reasons to scavenge. You get faster, you can find better stuff. Okay, so he's still overheating, so we're not going to eat dog food. We're not that desperate yet. I've already gone through here. in here. See how, like, I was just using Stone Hatchet then too, and it didn't freeze up on me. That's interesting. We're gonna go ahead and we're gonna eat these. Let's see. Come on, stop lagging. I honestly don't understand why. This is a local game. I'm not connecting over the network to play with anybody. I don't understand why there's this issue. I'll have to look into that and see if there's a remedy for this. And once it resumes, I'll show you guys some of the skills and stuff like that, since we have a lot of time left in the day. There we go. Alright, so go up here as it freezes on me again. So this is our these are the players, the list of players in the game. So see how many zombie kills I have, which is directly correlated to the score, what level my character is overall, how many times I've died, how many other players I've killed, so forth and so forth. If you're playing with friends, what you want to do is you want to go down to their name, go across over here, you're going to hit the little plus sign to add them as allies. And then you're going to tap on track and show on the map. So that way on the little compass up here, there's a little symbol or a little color that'll tell you which direction they are. And then you can see them on the map and it'll tell you how far away they are in kilometers. This is our journal. This is where a lot of the little information we can find is located. So like bedrolls, campfires, hot weather, anything that you've learned over the course of the game to this point, it will show up in here. Here's the quests. You can actually find little quests out in the world, but these are your basic survival. These are the first 8 that I did in the last episode. Over here is the skills. It's a little person up here with a little graduation cap on. So you got stuff like the survivor, which means you don't have to eat as often, and when you do eat, or everything that you do, you'll get more wellness, which is, I'll show you over here. Wellness is over here, and it caps out at 200. You start out with a wellness of 100, so technically you start out at 50%. And everything that you do is good based on the stuff that you eat. Like you go over here, for example, boiled eggs, it'll give me 0.32 wellness per boiled egg that I eat because it's a healthy food. Stuff like that nature. So going back over here, you got this over here. Every rank that you get, every level that you go up to 5, you use 10% less stamina per rank. So level 1, 10% less. Level 2, 20% less. So forth and so forth. Camel slows your thirst. You don't have to drink as much. And see that right here, there's a cost. So these first 5 are worth, each perk is worth 10 points, or it costs 10 points. If you go up here to the top right, I'll tell you how many points you have available to you. You can use them as you get them, you can save them up so you can get more and more stuff. I do believe that the most expensive perk is actually only like 10 points, but I think the price goes up the more ranks you earn, or the more ranks you buy. So for this one, athletics, I'm already level 4. So you don't have to use points to get these perks. So the more I run, the more I punch something, like it says up here, I can gain XP, which is this bar right here, towards the next level. Or I can spend 1 point to go up 1 level. Or this thing right here, Sexual Tyrannosaurus. Pretty much, I regain stamina faster with every rank I increase. So this, because it's a pretty good perk, it's going to cost me 10 points. So I'm not going to be able to afford it until I get to the next level, which I do believe I either might get 3 or I might get 4 points for my next level up. Knife guy, do more damage with blades, and I can keep stabbing for longer. Blunt weapons, do more damage with blunt weapons. So if I use, for example, this right here, the iron reinforced club, that is a blunt weapon. Every time I use that, I'll get more XP, so forth and so forth. And I'm already level 10 out of 100 in construction tools. So every time I buy something, every time, or sorry, every time I harvest something with like the stone axe, because that's the one tool that I have that's considered construction, because I can repair with it. Every time I use that, I get XP. So, and it's not just repairing anything; it's actually just by using it in general. So every time I use the stone axe down here to break down a or take down a tree or take down a door, I'm going to get XP. But the reason why this still says 1 point and I'm at level 10 is because I have not spent any points to upgrade this perk yet. And I'm hoping I don't get proved wrong. That's my thought process on this. So with that being said, it's now 7:30. We still have some stuff to search. And then we're going to head home and call it an episode. So I really hope you guys learned a little bit. I definitely had to do some wiki. I definitely had to watch a lot of I've been watching YouTube videos for years on this game. So I've learned a little bit, which is nice. It's always nice to do your own research, follow other people, so that way you kind of know what you're talking about. And then, like, right here, we can still reach the toilet from here. We are not going to take the poo. We're going to have to break through this. So we should be getting a level up in construction tools because of doing this right here. I think it's every swing. Yep, there we go. So we earn enough XP to get to the next level for that. Alright, level 5 in scavenging, which means we're going to find a little bit better stuff than we've been finding. Ooh, there we go. We'll do this. That. Bring it up here. This. We're going to eat. Bring up our person. And we're going to, you know, we're going to put the football helmet on. And we're going to put the goggles on. We're going to Mad Max it up a little bit. Ooh, here we go. Hunting rifle schematic. So we're going to take this. We're going to learn how to repair and build the hunting rifle as soon as the game unfreezes. And yes, I will definitely be looking into why the PS4 version is doing this. Because it doesn't do this on PC, it doesn't do this on Xbox, unless you're in a high spawn area. But I don't actually hear... I don't hear any zombies spawning outside, so I don't know why this is doing this. And I'm going to give it just a little bit more time. If it does not resume, we're just going to go ahead and oh, there we go. Read that. And take the paper. Did we even make it to where we wanted to go this episode? Yeah, we did. So my character still is going, he's still infected. He has less than 2 hours left. And the game freezes again. So I was talking to a friend of mine about this game. He is aware that, on my YouTube channel, he is aware that my YouTube channel has a Facebook page. And he is definitely interested in doing a stream of this via Xbox One, probably looking into doing Twitch. So if you are interested in seeing this on multiple platforms with somebody else, making it a little bit more interesting, a little bit more... ooh, yes, that's a good one. Now we can make a wrench. Alright. So if you're interested in seeing this in another aspect, like with a multiplayer, someone else that's gonna like commentate and just make this a little bit more interesting. Let me know in the comment section below. It's gonna be on Xbox One, like I said, via Twitch. Here we go. All right, one last check before we go. Did I get the car? Yes, okay. Car's empty. We're gonna head home. Never check that. Okay. Let's get some more stone before I go, though. So we're gonna be wrapping up this episode here in the next 20 game minutes or so. Like I mentioned, this YouTube channel actually has a Facebook page now. Go to facebook.com and do a search for BonsaiBingo88. It is the same as my gamer tag, PSN, and then also I will be putting a link to my Twitch, which, I guess it's time for us to call it a night. We're gonna head due south to get home, so I will definitely put a link to my Twitch page on here, so that way when the, internet is tolerant of an Xbox One, and I need to jump on Twitch, that you guys will get notified of that. So, we've made it home. As you can see, it's not that far. Alright, we're going to go ahead and put some stuff away, but I'm going to go ahead and put a cut in this here. If you guys are interested in seeing what I do during the nighttime since the zombies aren't running, let me know in the comment section below, and I will make the change for that. But for the time being, I'm going to bid you guys a good night, and I will see you guys on day 3. So if you are new here, click that like button, click that subscribe button, and definitely check out facebook.com, do a search for BonsaiBingo88, and I'll be putting links of all the playlists and all the, and every time I go to put up a video, I'll even devise a schedule that I'm going to try and keep on, keep up with. So, there is that. And lastly, I'll be putting up a an update video explaining when I'm going to be home, when I'm going to have more consistent internet, things of that nature. So, have a good night, and thanks for joining me. Talk to you guys later.